from Tampa Bay streaming news leader. This is ABC Action News.
Hello, I'm James Tully. Gray Diaz, a look at your forecast coming up. But first, our top story here on ABC Action News. We're staying on top of the latest out of Sarasota County, where remains were found during the search for Brian Laundrie, the person of interest in Gabby Petito's death. The attorney for Laundrie's parents, they say that there's a strong possibility these remains belong to Brian. They were found near a backpack and a notebook belonging to him at Myakahatchee Creek Environmental Park. That park is once again closed. The FBI says it's going to take some time before those remains are identified. Better check your fridge or your pantry. Onions are making some people sick nationwide. More than 600 people across the country have reported getting sick from a salmonella outbreak hitting onions. The CDC says that red, white, and yellow onions coming from Mexico and distributed to grocery stores across the nation, including here in Florida, are contributing to this. The last shipment was back in August, but they had a 90-day shelf life. So if you have onions in your home without a sticker saying where they came from, just throw them out. Several Florida lawmakers now working to stop prison inmates from working for little or no pay. For years, the state, universities, and others have used inmates to generate millions of hours of work. Representative Diane Hart and Senator Bobby Powell have proposed a joint resolution to officially end this. Supporters of it call it a human rights issue.
Understand, I'm not asking for people not to work. What I am saying is, don't work me for free.
If passed by lawmakers and then by voters, prison laborers would be compensated for their work. Lawmakers returned for the session in January. Starting today, you can get tickets to see the defending Stanley Cup champs play a game outdoors. The Tampa Bay Lightning take on the Nashville Predators in this year's Stadium Series on February 26th at Nissan Stadium, where the Titans play. Today's tickets will go on sale on Ticketmaster. And today's the start of the season for the Cross Bay Ferry. This season, they're extending the hours. The service connects Tampa and St. Pete, runs through May 22nd of next year. An adult ticket will run you 10 bucks. Some days, it can run as late as 11 p.m., helping you avoid traffic on the bridges. And Greg, you said it times out perfectly for a nice dinner in St. Pete if you're coming from Tampa.
Absolutely. The schedule there, really nice on the weekends. And then during the week, so you've got many options. And today, the perfect day to take the ferry out there. Air temperatures will be in the upper 80s. Once you get out over the bay, it'll be in the mid 80s. The key today's forecast, number one, the wind, it's going to be very light. So just a light chop out on the bay, that ferry should have great water conditions. That feels like temperature getting up there closer to 90, thanks to dew points that won't fall back into the 50s like they did yesterday in the low 60s. Still very comfortable today. Does turn a little bit more humid by the weekend. Check out your weekend forecast in the ABC Action News app. James.
Thank you, Greg. Get your news 24/7 right here on our free stream News channel. Have a great day.